March the 17th, 2020, Lisburn Distillery appointed former player Johnny Clapham as their new manager. 91 days later, and Clapham eventually got the chance this week to meet his players for the first time face-to-face, albeit on a socially distanced basis. Clapham has done his best to adapt to the unprecedented circumstances, although the Donaghadee native admits it has been an excessively frustrating time.
I think the most frustrating part of it is not being able to meet the players face-to-face. You know, we've spent a lot of time over the 3 months on the phone with some text messages, and I think that's the most frustrating thing for me, is not meeting them one-to-one and interacting that way to sell your vision and tell them how you want the club to be, you know, how you want it to run.
Although unable to oversee training sessions for the last 3 months in person, manager Clapham has ensured that the club have been able to utilise not only modern technology, but also to draw on experience from within the club to ensure a basic level of player fitness has been retained during the lockdown.
The very start, you know, we'll have Jack Clark, who runs his own gym, and the players had actually made the decision themselves. They thought it would be a good idea to first interact through him, putting on a Zoom class and using his expertise in the gym. And so we worked two nights a week. We were doing a Wednesday night and a Saturday, and we were doing Zoom workouts. So for me personally and Ryan, you know, we're doing, it was hard sessions, to be honest, but to be fair, you know, all the players were joining in on it as well, and I think we got a lot out of it.
Thankfully for all concerned, a recent change in government legislation now permits small group training, which in turn has enabled Clapham to organise small, brief sessions which will not only aid the players' fitness, but also, and more importantly, will provide him with the ideal opportunity to meet his players for the first time.
It's all good as speaking on the phone, but actually to see players, look them in the eye. For me, the communication side is the most important thing for anything. So to get them, not just for me to get to see them, but also them to get to see me in terms of, you know, how I work and who I am as a person. I think that's vitally important. So I think tonight for our first training session, we're just able to get out onto the grass and let them just be themselves, hear the banter, you know, and just get a ball at their feet. You know, it was very important. So tonight, I think, was very important.
With no sign of a resumption of play for local football on the immediate horizon, the return to training may well be short-lived for Clapham and his players, a situation which is already considered.
It's only going to be short-term. You know, we can only manage to get three or maybe five, six sessions in, because really we've no goal, we've nothing to play for. You can't really work on anything, your shape, because there's no intensity in the sessions. You know, we still have to stick to the guidelines. So really I think it's just important for us to, you know, just see each other as much as we can. You know, so if we get about six sessions in, then we're just going to have to wait until the next decision's made, when the pre-season's going to start and when the league's going to start.
Without an agreed date for the return to competitive games, it may well be that Clapham has to spend a lot more time in limbo, but there can be little doubt that once football does make its long-awaited return, the distillery and their new manager will be fighting fit and round to go once again.